Everyone, my name is Katie. Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to do the tag created by the lovely Holly Davis at Write Holly Davis. This is her NaNoWriMo survival kit tag. I also wanted to give a shout out real quick at the beginning that I will be having a month's worth of prompts for Instagram and for Twitter. So check out my Instagram account. All my accounts are listed below, but my Instagram is Katie Knightley Author. And then my Twitter is Kat Knightley. So we'll be posting those a few days beforehand, so everyone can get like familiarized with it and share about it, and then we'll get going on November 1st. I love nano time. Like, I absolutely love it. I know a lot of people hate like the pressure of it, but I'm a really great drafter, and so it's not that hard for me to like get going. But this year has been insane with the go and getting two books ready. We'll see if I just take a relaxing break this nano and just let it be what happens. But I love these questions. Thank you, Holly, for creating this tag. So question number one is, what are you working on for NaNoWriMo this year? If you saw my video about nano plus my other updates, I am working on a young adult contemporary with some romance in there. It's definitely a summer beach read. The setting is an island on the beach, working at the pier with all the carnival-esque rides and food and games. And so just kind of, it's a setting that's similar to one near me, and I am really excited to explore that along with like the eco-friendly side of things. So like turtle nest watching, beach litter cleanup, dolphin rehab. I'm hoping to incorporate all of that stuff into my plot along with the romance aspect that I'm hoping will be a fake relationship. I keep trying for that and it keeps getting rewritten, so hopefully this time it'll stick. Question two, what apps do you use to help you write and stay motivated? I love the writing community on Instagram and Twitter. That monthly prompt that I created is a really fun way to keep engaged, but it's also a bit of a time suck. So I love Trello. That's where my outline is, where I look to see what's coming, what's next, reminder of who my characters are, world building, all of that, and kind of just helping me. I like writing basically like a chapter a day if I can. So that's kind of my goals. I kind of want to see about, I think Holly mentioned a time app that tracks your time on stuff, and I'm thinking about getting into that, but I'm pretty good at block scheduling. So that's kind of just in my brain what I'm gonna do. Question three, where do you like to write and what's your favorite writing spot? I'm definitely a desk person. I need like my back and shoulders. I sit at my desk all day for work too, and if I'm on a bed or a couch, I like slump or I'm like weird. So I like a desk. I try to keep things level, but it's really hard because I'm short, so my legs or my arms or something's always off, but definitely a desk person. What are your writing space must-haves, i.e. candles, pillows, favorite notebook, etc.? I actually don't have a lot of must-haves. I need my phone, I need my water, and everything else is online. So like, I do a Google Doc for my document, and then Trello, which is an online app too. And so everything's kind of right there. If I need, I also have my notes about writing craft books on there. I do have writing craft books in general that I could have on hand, like Save the Cat, but I pretty much just go in. I just need my phone, my water, maybe some snacks, and get going. I'm not one of those people who does candles or playlists or music, and I think that's weird to some people, but it's just what works for me, and I really like silence. Question five, what are your favorite drinks and snacks to have when writing? So water, if it's in the morning or even like an afternoon pick-me-up, I love coffee. I probably need to start hopping off of it and like switching to other stuff, but I love coffee. And then snack-wise, stuff that's not gonna get my keyboard dirty. I really like peanut M&Ms. That's what I used all last nano, and it was kind of like a reward system. So if like I wrote, you know, 100 words, I got a peanut M&M or something like that. But I don't know, I don't really eat while I write. It's actually one way that like, I'm pretty much a hobbit eater. I eat every 2 hours, but when I'm writing, I'll just push through the hunger pains. And then at the end, I'm like, oh snap, I need to go get a sandwich or something. But yeah, I just like zone in. Do any of y'all just like zone in? Number six, what are your favorite writing distractions? If I'm not zoned in, my distractions are like Instagram and Twitter. If the writing community or my friends are talking, like, I want to be a part of that. My relaxed time, which I think is later actually, I don't know if these are distractions or rewards, but I like watching my Netflix and Hulu shows, so I'll do that. I don't really like to read while I'm writing. I do have some audiobooks going right now, so like that might be a factor, but my writing distractions are just like, if I don't have a, you know, alone time, anything else is going to be a distraction. Noise, family, my pets. Yeah, if I let myself get sucked into the internet. Especially, oh my gosh, when you're looking up an answer to a question and then you go on a rabbit hole forever. What are your favorite ways to get back on track? That is just putting my butt back in that chair, looking at where I am. I like when I do Nano to leave notes to myself for where it's going so I can just hop right back in. But I'll even look at my Trello and see what's happening, or if I have left notes for myself, just to trigger something right off the bat so I'm just not staring at a blank page. What are your writing rewards and milestones? I really like Holly, what she does with buying a NaNoWriMo like shirt or poster or whatever at the end. I think that's really, really cool. Rewards for me, I actually haven't really thought about this. I don't really reward myself. But yeah, I really like just at the end, if I make it or not, buying from the NaNoWriMo site and supporting them and getting some really cool merch. Tag three friends. If you want to do this tag, please do it. Let me know. Come back to this one. Tell me, hey, I did it, and I will go and check yours out. I love the Nano time, the Nano writing community. It's just all about like helping each other and like cheering each other on, and I absolutely love that. So also feel free to follow me on Instagram and Twitter, YouTube, obviously, if you're not subscribed yet. Also, I will link my Nano name down below so that we can be buddies over there too. Good luck everyone for Nano, and I can't wait to see what your answers are. Leave comments down below for me about any that you matched on or that are different, like if you love music and candles or whatever. And also, duh, let me know what y'all are writing, what you're gonna be working on for Nano, if you're gonna be a rebel or not. I might be, I don't know. I might be working on multiple projects, but are you gonna be a rebel or not? And then what your project is, age and genre. I can't wait to hear from you guys. Happy writing, good luck during Nano, and I will see y'all next time. Bye.